to us and your husband's fortune.
SoapNet. Every day, a new twist.
There you are. I'm starting to worry.
I'm sorry.
I thought we had a lunch date.
I couldn't make it.
How come you didn't call me?
I said I was sorry. Okay?
Okay. You're forgiven. Come on, I got this, the best table in the house, and could we order right away? I'm starved. Let's get one of those big spinach salads and we'll...
I'm not hungry.
After I waited an hour here for you, besides, you look like you could use some
more. I said I'm not hungry.
Okay. I'll eat by myself. So, what kept you at the hospital?
I had to talk to a patient and his family.
Oh, before I forget, I picked up your tux at the cleaners. Wait till you see what I'm wearing to the party. I hope you don't think it's too flashy.
Listen, would you stop, Lisa? Just stop it.
What I said?
I mean, I just get back from the hospital, Lisa, and you already start talking about tuxedos and parties. And did it ever occur to you that I may not want to go to this party?
Jamie, what's wrong?
Everything.
You know, my brother is not the kind of guy to change his mind easily. You must have talked very fast and very good.
Well, I had a very good argument. All John had to do was just hear it out.
Well, I, for one, really appreciate it, and I want to thank you.
No, Michael, I should be thanking you. It was your idea. You know, I have a very strong hunch that John's speech tonight is going to make people sit up and think.
Well, let's hope it makes them sit up and pull out the checkbook.
Oh, I know. Wouldn't that be great? I would really love to turn this party into a real full-fledged fundraiser.
Well, you know you got a check coming from me.
Oh, Michael, you've already done too much already, but I'll take it.
Well, you know, Kathleen was really a terrific person.
And yeah.
Well, the Vietnam vets and my brothers.
I know that. You support about a dozen different organizations. I talked to all of them.
Oddly enough, you picked the one that I hadn't heard of. But if these guys need help, they got it.
Columbia Pulp and Paper.
Yeah.
Columbia Pulp and Paper.
You negotiated their old contract with Brava. I read it last night. It's a good piece of work, Cass.
Oh, yeah, Columbia Pulp and Paper. Okay, yeah, right. Thanks, Zach. Thanks. Hey, look at this place, huh?
Well, is it not enough, or is it too much? What?
Oh, it's terrific, really.
Cass, do you like it?
Kathleen would have loved it.
Hey, John!
Hey,
John.
Hey,
John. Look, this is no good.
Why? What's wrong?
What am I going to say to those vets? Take the $25,000 and go home, be happy that you helped these good people not feel guilty anymore?
Hey, why don't you just shut your face?
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my. I'm so excited. You know, I've been on pins and needles waiting for you to come home.
Why? Did something arrive?
Wait until you see. Look. A key. Oh, and that's not the best part of it either. Oh, out in the driveway. You're going to be so surprised. There's a little red sports car out there.
You're kidding.
Yes, and it's all tied with a big red ribbon.
That's amazing.
Well, didn't you see it when you came in?
Bridget, how could I not see a little red sports car with a ribbon tied around it sitting in the driveway, huh?
Well, now I guess that makes sense, doesn't it? I guess I'm just so excited. Oh, my. Yes, you know, I love the smell of a new car.
Well, then maybe you can get Victoria to take you for a spin in it and smell it, too.
Victoria!
Oh, do you think red's too flashy?
Oh, no, I think it's grand. Oh, no, it's grand.
Victoria! Well, she is home, isn't she?
Oh, yes, indeed she is, yes.
Victoria, could you come down here a minute? Look at this.
What is it?
Have you looked out in the driveway lately?
Yeah.
What do you think?
Of the little red sports car?
Yes, do you like it?
Well, Donna, what's not to like?
Well, it's all yours.
Mine?
Yes, I bought it for you.
Why?
As a present. Well, I mean, that's what mothers do for daughters that they love.
Well, you can take it back from me, too. I don't want it.
Thank you. Gloria, wait.
I didn't ask for a car, Donna.
I thought you'd be through.
You thought I could be bought.
I was just trying to make you happy.
Don't you think it's a little late for that?
Well, I was hoping it wasn't.
I don't want your presence, Donna. Don't you understand that? You don't seem to want anything from me. I keep trying and trying with you, and I just feel like I get slapped in the face.
Do you expect me to feel sorry for you?
Well, I expect you to feel something.
Oh, I do.
What? Hatred? Resentment? What, Victoria? I mean, I can't deal with this until you tell me.
Victoria, your mother is trying so hard. Can't you at least try to explain to her how you feel?
I am not the one that should be explaining things around here.
I'll leave the two of you alone.
What do you feel, Victoria? Haven't you figured that out by now, Donna?
No. No, I haven't. Look, maybe I did make a mistake by buying you this car and all these other presents. But I just wanted you to understand how much you mean to me. I know I'm not too subtle sometimes, but that's the way I am. I buy things for people that I love.
Donna, that's pathetic.
Well, it was genuine. You know, sometimes I fantasize about you and I becoming great friends.
Parents are not supposed to be their children's best friends, Donna. But you are my child.
And I love you, and I just want to share things with you.
You can't have it all your way. Victoria, I would do anything to make you realize how much you mean to me.
Look, if not for my sake, for Michael's. Please don't push me away.
Sorry. Oh, honey.
Cass, honey, please.
I'm sorry. John, I'm sorry.
It's okay.
No, it's not. It's just that tonight means a lot to me.
And I didn't mean to spoil it.
I mean, this foundation is in memory of my wife, and you're talking like it's some kind of,
Listen, I have a reputation for never saying the right thing. Kathleen sounds like she was loved by everyone.
Yes, she was.
So I'm the one who should apologize.
Tell you what, why don't you get back on the elevator, walk back off, and just come in again, okay?
No, because nothing is going to spoil this party tonight.
No, of course not. Nothing will. I think I know what you're feeling.
No, you don't.
I think you wonder why you survived and someone else didn't.
That's part of it.
I know that feeling.
Cass.
Alicia, I came that close to saving her.
Honey, you did everything that you could.
I think I did, but I can't know that for sure. There'll always be that little bit of doubt.
With me, there's more than just a little bit of doubt.
How's that?
And, I was this close every day. That doesn't cut it, does it?
It didn't for me.
John, is that your speech for tonight?
Huh?
The notebook.
No, I'm not giving a speech.
It's blank.
Like my mind.
Hey, man, is this... mean you're not going to speak? You are going to speak, aren't you?
Listen, if I were to tell all of these people that you've invited how I felt about these guys, I don't think that they would understand.
Well, tell you what, why don't you try it out on us?
Right.
These aren't words for a party.
John, whatever it is that you have to say, it's fine.
It is, you know, really. Please.
We'll see.
This is Kathleen's party, and she was the most honest person I ever knew.
Well, I'm sorry I never met her.
But what I'm trying to say is, you can say whatever you want. We can take it.
Yeah,
Is Scott LaSalle back yet? He isn't. I need those papers today. Well, I hope nothing's holding it up.
What are you doing?
The air.
What, you're turning off the air?
Yeah, the jet thing was blowing right in my face. I just wanted to shift it over a little bit.
Oh, okay.
Is it bothering you?
No.
Good. Looks like we're going to be sitting together all the way to Bay City.
Yeah.
My name's Scott LaSalle. You have a name?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm Don.
Don.
Nice to meet you.
Me too. So you live in Bay City?
No, I'm just visiting.
Yeah, I live there.
Oh, Bay City native, huh?
Well, not exactly. I grew up out of the country. Paraguay?
Well, tell me about it.
What about?
Well, tell me about Paraguay. I mean, I know that it's in South America, and mm-hmm. I know that the capital is, Asunción.
Asunción, yeah. Right.
Yeah, I'm good at capitals. But what else about it?
Not much, unless you're into exports and natural resources.
I mean, I love resources. I mean, Paraguay has, valuable minerals, right?
Uh-huh.
It's rich in natural resources.
Right.
Okay.
Were you an economics major, by any chance?
No, it's just that my school was really, really strict when it came to geography. Was strict when it came to everything.
No, which school was this?
Miss Brierley's.
Sounds kind of old.
Old-fashioned.
Ivy-covered walls, that kind of thing.
Plaid skirts, green blazers. What was that?
That's a little turbulence.
Flying is not one of my favorite ways to travel.
Never would have guessed.
Mm.
Say, why don't you tell me about your school?
Well, it wasn't that bad, really. I like the girls, and I even like some of the teachers. But I think the best thing about it is that I'm finished with it.
You're free. Yeah, I remember the feeling.
Well, I'm not free for long, though.
Well, what are you doing next?
I'm going to college. It's okay. Music major.
There's a little rough weather ahead. Please fasten your seatbelts.
We're gonna crash, right?
Sorry. I shouldn't have snapped at you.
It's all right.
Well, I didn't even let you talk.
You were annoyed.
Well, I had no right to be.
Jamie, you're allowed to get annoyed with me.
Not without reason.
I was rambling on about a silly party and you were feeling depressed.
Yeah, well, I had a bad day and I took it out on you and I shouldn't have.
You can take it out on me anytime.
Might regret saying that.
Can you talk about it?
Well, it's about a patient of mine. He's a young man, about 25. He only came into my office about a month ago, and already we've become like friends. He's got this terrific sense of humor. He's one of the funniest people I've ever known. I mean, you'd really love him. You would.
I thought you were trying not to get emotionally involved with your patients.
Yeah, well, I'm not doing very well at that.
I'm not surprised.
Anyway, he came in with a very bad cough. He said it was getting worse and worse, and he couldn't shake it. It turned out to be pneumocystosis.
What's that?
Well, it's a type of pneumonia. His condition began to deteriorate rapidly about 2 weeks ago, and his breathing is very poor, and he lost about 15 pounds. And we had to hospitalize him the day before yesterday.
It's awful.
And he hates being in hospitals. I mean, not that he's lost his sense of humor, he still manages to crack everybody up. The doctors, the nurses, the orderlies, everybody loves him. They're crazy about him. I mean, here he is, as sick as can be, and he's trying to make everybody feel good.
And you still don't know what's wrong with him?
Well, I'm waiting for the lab results. They should be in today.
What do you think it is?
The test is for HIV.
What's that?
I think I may have diagnosed my first case of AIDS.
Hey, buddy. You were joking, weren't you? I mean, you're going to
give that speech.
No, I don't think so.
We're all counting on you, Jenner.
Look, I could hurt this deal just as easily as I can help it.
Now, how do you figure that?
Mike, I'm no speech maker. I'm going to end up looking like a jerk. And what's worse, I'm going to make those vets look like jerks.
John, I have a feeling this is just nerves. It's just a case of stage fright.
Call it whatever you want.
Once you get up there and start, you'll do fine.
Look, I know the vets need somebody to speak for them, but it's not going to be me. Look, you were there. Why don't you give the speech?
No, no, no. Wait a minute, man. You're always telling me I flew a chopper. I didn't see what it was really like.
That doesn't mean that I can give speeches about it.
All you got to do is get up there and tell them what it was like, what happened, and what it's like now.
What Felicia needs is someone who's used to being up in front of people, who has a way with words, is eloquent.
No, John, the truth is eloquent. Just get up there and tell them the truth.
Nobody wants to hear the truth.
Felicia asked you because she wanted to hear what you have to say. You don't have to worry about it, man. What comes from the heart reaches the heart. Just get up there, all right? The guys are counting on you. Felicia's counting on you. I'm counting on you. But most of all, the grunts, man. You got to help them one more time.
Excuse me, John. You got a phone call, and the guy wants me to give you a message.
What guy?
Well, he just said for you to break out the cribbage board, and then he called you some names. The only respectable one I can repeat is, lousy blankety-blank cheat.
Sergeant Freeling?
Yeah, that's the guy.
Howard Freeling? He's in a wheelchair. He stepped on a landmine. His legs got all mangled up. He lay out in the field for what seemed like hours. I couldn't get to him. We were pinned down.
But you got to him, right? Eventually.
Eventually, yeah. Yeah. I just wish I could have medevaced him sooner. A couple weeks later, I got hit, and we ended up in the same hospital in Yokosuka, Japan. He taught me how to play cutthroat cribbage. That's right.
Yeah, he got an invitation to the party.
How do you get an invitation? Who knew? You just don't stop, do you?
Well, he said he's looking forward to tilting a few blankety-blank drinks with you.
Okay, guys. Mm-hmm. Message from Donna.
Yes?
John's tuxedo has arrived.
Well, then I guess we better go, huh?
Yeah, I better start thinking, getting ready myself. I'll okay. See you tonight.
Yeah, I'll see you guys.
Okay, take care. All right. See you later. Look, I'm sorry if I put pressure on you there earlier. I just think you're the guy we need as our spokesman.
If I speak, still haven't made up my mind yet.
Are you okay?
Yes, I'm fine. I mean, here I am trying to be motherly, and I end up doing this, huh?
I'm sorry I was so angry about the car.
No, honey, I understand. I can't blame you for that.
Did you tell Michael about this?
No, I haven't.
Don, he's going to be furious. He's already refused to buy me a car.
Michael wants us to be a family. He wants us to love each other.
Is that why you bought me the car? Because you love me.
Oh, honey, I told you that.
It's not just to buy my cooperation.
I don't want to buy anything from you. I just want you to let me love you the way you allow your father to.
Hey, whose new car?
Mine.
See, all this turbulence is just air being pushed up from the mountains down there. It gets kind of rocky up here sometimes.
Well, the wings aren't going to fall off, are they?
They're pretty careful about that. Besides, they can withstand a little bit more than we're going through right now.
You sure?
Mm-hmm. Say, Don, you don't know a lot about airplanes, though, do you?
I know they crash.
Well, the odds of that are pretty high.
I just know what happens, Scott. I mean, I've heard the news.
Well, it's always in the news because it rarely ever happens.
You know, I've read a couple of books on flight, and I thought that it would help me get over my fear.
Well, I think maybe you've been reading the wrong kind of books.
It wouldn't matter what I read. If we were meant to fly, we would have been born with wings, you know? If only the train didn't take so
long. There's still a lot of choppiness. Flight attendants, please be seated.
Oh, no. We're going to crash right now, right? Did they get the test results?
I have to call them back in half an hour.
What happens if the diagnosis is positive?
First, he has to be told.
Are you the one who has to do that?
I'm his doctor.
Does he have any family?
Just his parents. No brothers or sisters.
Have you met them?
Yeah, they're there night and day. They're wonderful people.
How are they taking it?
They're terrified for him. But they're going to see him through this. That's for sure. At least he's got that.
Jimmy, how will you tell them?
That their only son is probably going to die?
It's going to be hard for you.
Not as hard as it will be for them.
I hate to see you go through this.
Lisa, it's not me that I'm worried about. Don't you understand? It's this terrific, bright young man who is probably going to lose his life. And the worst part is, he's going to suffer before he does more and more every day. And no matter how sick he gets, and no matter how much agony he's in, there's not a thing I can do about it. I can't help him. I can't help him at all.
Wait.
No, I've got to get back to the hospital.
I'll go with you.
No, I want to do this by myself.
That's what you think.
That car outside is yours?
Well, that's what I just said, isn't it?
You've outdone yourself, Donna.
Victoria, you really do want the car.
Donna, who wouldn't want the car?
In that case, here is your key.
I guess it's time I take it for a spin.
Oh, Victoria, just remember, it is a symbol.
A nice symbol.
You are a Hudson, and I don't want you ever to forget that.
That certainly is a nice symbol. An expensive one as well. I remember when you could pick up a symbol for under $10, a rose, bottle of cologne. Times sure have changed.
Victoria, maybe we should wait to tell
you. No, there's a little red sports car out front there. Do you know whose it is? Is somebody going to answer me?
Michael, John, hello.
Come on, whose car is that out there?
Oh, I wonder who that could be. Are you expecting anyone, Victoria?
No, I'm not.
Oh, my gosh, look at the time. We better start getting ready for the party. Oh, John, Bridget took your tux upstairs. You still have to get your hair done, you know.
Mm-hmm. Donna, I don't like it when you do this. Come on, tell me, what's going on here?
Mr. Michael, Miss Falkland's here to see you.
Thank you, Bridget. Yeah, Jane?
Well, I had to run by the overnight express mail office, and I would have called you first, but I just didn't want to interrupt you or anything, but I wanted to give you this memo in person. I thought it might be better instead of reading it to you over the phone.
Thank you. Oh, no. The SEC has suspended trading in the Spalding Corporation.
Well, is that bad?
Donna, this is a disaster. Look, I'll be in my office, okay?
Well, wait. You're going to make it back in time for the party, aren't you?
Honey, I hope so.
All right. Well, I guess I'll just toddle along myself.
Jane, wait.
Yes, John?
I don't know where to pick you up for the party tonight.
Oh, that's no problem.
It is if you don't tell me.
Oh, right. Well, I could just meet you here.
That'd be fine, whatever you want.
Well, since I know the way here and you've never been to my place, so how could you know the way there? We could just meet where we both know the way. Wouldn't that be more convenient?
Sure. Come on, I'll walk you out to the stables.
Oh, thank you. That's John Tate.
They make a lovely couple, don't they?
How did it happen?
Well, I suggested that John take her to the party, and he agreed. He thought it was a good idea.
You fixed them up?
Well, I wouldn't exactly say I fixed them up. I did make the suggestion. Listen, my hairdresser is waiting upstairs for me, and he's going to take care of you next, so don't go too far, all right?
No, I'll be right here.
So, your Uncle John is dating your father's secretary.
Do you really believe that?
Well, perhaps you won't have to talk to your father after all, Vicky.
Don't you understand, Uncle Peter? Donna set this whole thing up. Uncle John would not ask her out on his own.
Oh, I find Miss Falkland rather attractive in a bizarre sort of way.
That's not the point.
Then what is?
This is a setup. I mean, a cover.
A cover? Of course.
Donna wants to make it look like Uncle John has a girlfriend.
Oh, why didn't I think of that? Yes, Michael and John, Donna and Miss Falkland. What a peculiar foursome.
So you think I'm right?
I think it's possible Falkland is a cover, yeah. What? So where does that leave you?
Oh, back to square one.
Yeah. So you're going to go ahead and talk to your father.
I wish I knew what to do.
I thought you did know what to do.
Well, I thought I did, but Donna was just so sincere right now. Uncle Peter, she acted like she loved us so much. Mm-hmm. I mean, especially Michael. Then Uncle John walks into the room and the way they look at each other...
Yeah, it's confusing. It's confusing.
One minute I feel one thing, and the next minute I feel something totally different.
Yeah, well, perhaps you should wait until... the situation becomes clear to you.
I can't do that, Uncle Peter. I mean, what if my father would find out on his own? Why can't I just tell him and just get it over with?
Because you love your father. And Vicky, breaking his heart is going to be a very painful thing to do.
It rained almost the whole time we were there.
Well, at least it broke the hot spell. I like the rain. It's kind of fitting, you know?
I know what you mean.
Chad, if there's anything I can do...
Oh, thanks, Felicia. The arrangements have already been taken care of.
When is the funeral?
A couple of days. I just gotta try and find a priest.
Hey, you know what I think? I think you look like you need some nourishment. Let's get something to eat, huh?
All right, go find a table. Anyone you want, I'll send a waiter over.
Thank you.
Sit down. What a way to end up, huh?
Yeah.
Alone and nowhere.
What happened? The guy she lived with just, what, disappeared?
The guy was a scum. He just packed a bag and left. Nothing.
Such a rotten way to live.
It's her choice. She threw her life away.
Chad, didn't she ever try to get out of it?
Every 5 minutes. I mean, a couple times, it really looked like she was going to stick it out. You know, she had made plans for a straight life. Talked about the future. You should have read the want ads.
Well, what happened?
Oh, she'd get depressed. Feel like nobody loved her or needed her. And I wasn't much help in that department.
Hey, now I know you. I know you were a good son. As good as she'd let you be.
Well, I wasn't good enough to keep her from going back to the streets.
Come on, Chad. Don't you think that she could take responsibility for her own life?
You know, one time it really looked like she was going to pull it all together. She was living with this guy. I mean, not much of a guy. But he was there, you know?
Yeah, I know what you mean.
And I had saved up $20,000.
Wow. That's a lot of money.
Well, I made good money then. Anyway, I gotten it all together in cash and I just gave it to her.
What did she do with it?
She wanted to open up a business. She had taken some hairdressing courses in her spare time and wanted to open up a beauty salon. She picked out the most beautiful place. Well, we both did. And we went back to get the money.
And the guy was gone. And so was the money.
Well, I told you about this.
No, but I used to be a cop, I know.
I had so many dreams that were just shot down.
I know you did.
But there's one dream that nobody's gonna touch. My little sister.
Tell me about her. You never talk about her.
I got her. Got her out of all this mess early in the game. I kept her away from everything. Till now. She's coming home to the first tragedy she's ever had in her life. She doesn't even know it yet.
All right, thank you very much. Haven't you ever heard of Archimedes?
Well, he sounds like one of those professional wrestlers.
Not exactly. See, he's the guy that discovered why objects float in water.
But what does that have to do with flying?
Well, to understand that, you'd have to understand Bacon.
As in BLT?
No. Bacon is a guy who read what Archimedes wrote about. And then he got his own idea, and he figured that possibly this could apply to the sky. Maybe things could float in air like they float in water.
Well, boats don't drop 30,000 feet and fall into a million tiny little pieces. Boats float.
So do planes.
Says who?
Bacon. You see, he figured if man could... Suppose he was referring to women, too.
Bigger them.
Anyways, he figured if a machine could be built that would float on air, then it would support the weight. And he was right. The machine was built. The air is supporting us, and we're living proof of it.
So far.
So what do you think?
I think it's nice of you to distract me from the fact that we are going to crash.
Damn it.
What? What's wrong?
This tie. What kind of sadist designs a tie that you can't tie?
You're just not used to it, that's all. Here, why don't you let me help you?
No, that's... I'll figure it out myself.
I'm really excited about this party, aren't you?
Yeah, very much so. I love parties. Especially society bashes like these, where people give away all kinds of money so that they won't feel guilty about living in 42-room mansions while millions of people starve to death.
Why do you have to be so cynical?
What the hell did you do to your hair?
What? What's wrong with it?
It's not you.
I thought it was nice.
Looks like you're trying to be someone you're not. I remember a time when you didn't have to do that. A time when you'd go after horses who'd thrown you. Clothes would be torn. And grass in your hair. You'd catch those horses and you'd jump up on them and dig your heels into them and use your whip. And you'd show them who was boss. And you could get away with that then. Because you were as wild as those horses.
I am different now.
was out exercising one of the horses one day, and I looked up and I saw this beautiful girl running through the fields. She was out of breath, her cheeks were flushed, her hair was flying in the wind. I thought that was the most beautiful girl I had ever seen.
Donna?
What?
I said, how are you different now?
That girl doesn't exist. John, don't you understand that? I am not that girl anymore.
I wonder what Bacon would have thought about all this. Stewardess's movies, music.
He would have thought we were nuts. I mean, Bacon didn't fly anywhere, did he?
No.
No, because he was no dummy. I mean, he might have written about it, but there's no way that he was going to make a reservation. I mean, you're not going to find that Bacon guy flying 30,000 feet over Chicago.
Hey. Listen, we are not going to crash. Okay.
Why did I do this? I mean, I just could have taken the bus.
Now, come on, it takes forever.
Yeah, that's what Chad said.
Chad?
My brother.
Wait a minute, what's your last name?
Rollo.
You're kidding me. You're kidding me.
Why would I kid about
I know
like
him.
That? Oh, really?
I can't believe what a small world this is. I know him. Are you going here to visit him?
Well, I don't really know what's going on.
Well, what do you mean?
Well, Chad called me up and asked me to visit him, but I just think that there's something more than that. I mean, I think that there's something wrong.
I bet you were a great big brother.
Best thing I ever did for her. To get her out of there.
When did you do that?
She was about 12. She looked like a teenager. So beautiful. The last thing I was gonna have happen was my little sister walking around that neighborhood.
So where did you send her?
School. A little smart Eastern school for girls. She boarded there year round.
She never came home?
Well, she came home once or twice, but only when I was doing okay, and Mom was off the streets. Anyway, I let her stay for a couple days, and I made sure she'd be on her way back to school.
So she never knew anything about your mom, huh?
No. Never. And she never will. Her plane is landing in an hour. I have no idea what I'm going to say to her. Break her heart.
Well, even if I do say so myself, I think this place is ready for a gala.
Bring on the guests.
No, not looking like this.
You look beautiful. My beautiful friend. How can I ever thank you?
Be happy. I'll see you tonight.
Mm-hmm.
How did they take it?
Well, they're strong and brave. All those good things.
You must be relieved.
Relieved? Lisa, maybe you don't get it. A 25-year-old man is going to die.
I just meant that...
Yeah, I know what you meant, Lisa. You thought I must be relieved that he didn't fall apart. That his parents didn't go to pieces right before me. Well, I am not. This is just the beginning, Lisa. And it's not going to get any better. It never does with this disease.
Jamie, I'm sorry.
I feel so stupid. Here I tell the guy and his parents that his pneumonia is AIDS-related, and they're calm. And they can take it. And here I am falling apart.
What's wrong with that?
Because I have to be tougher, Lisa. I can't help the guy if I feel like crying every time I look at him.
Jamie, this is the first case of AIDS you've had to deal with.
I feel like a fool.
Don't say that. You are a compassionate, caring man.
Your heart is breaking for this man and his family. Is that a crime?
I have to be stronger, Lisa. I can't help him. I have to be. He has to know that I'm doing everything I can possibly do for him.
And he will. But you're with me right now. You can cry and be angry and feel sorry for yourself and scream anything you want. And I'll still love you. And maybe you'll feel better for getting all of that out.
How'd you get so smart?
Loving you.
You know what I need?
What?
I need to get out of this hospital for a while.
Good idea.
You don't happen to know of any parties going on, do you?
You're in luck. I know of a very special party. Would you like to go?
On one condition.
What?
You come with me.
I think that can be arranged.
And one more condition, too.
What?
That we dance. I really need to dance.
I just spoke to the airport. They said her plane landed 20 minutes ago.
But you said it was delayed. Well,
that's what they told me. I gotta get out there.
Okay.
I'll see you, MJ. Don't want. Don't want. Don't want.
Well, what's the matter?
This darn tie.
Would you please let me do that? You think you're doing? Victoria?